Struggling with too many emails? By the end of this video, you'll know how to use Outlook and Microsoft ToDo together to tame your inbox and get more done. I've got new videos on Microsoft Teams and Microsoft 365 coming out every Tuesday, so make sure you hit the subscribe button and the bell icon to get notified every time I post a new video. I'm Gavin Jones, a former transformation manager for a Fortune 500 company, and I now help organizations of any size with modern workplace transformations. If you're interested in working together, then stick around to the end of the video to find out more. Okay, so if you're struggling with emails, before we jump in to look at Outlook or ToDo, you wanna get some basics right first. So you wanna schedule time in your calendar to do emails. So you can start with three times a day, then try to get down to one time a day that you're doing emails. And every other time, you want to turn off incoming emails. So during that time that you scheduled, that's for processing emails. And processing emails is to get everything out of your inbox, either in to do a task, or just to archive it, or just to send it on to someone else and delegate it. That's all you want to do in your processing time, is just get stuff out of your inbox. And the benefit of using a task management system like Microsoft ToDo is that then it's got your agenda in as well as everyone else's agenda. So the Outlook inbox is just gonna be everybody else's wants of your time rather than anything that you want to do yourself. So getting everything into one inbox in a task management system is probably the best thing I think you should do if you're struggling with too many emails. So start with scheduling time for email first, and then we'll have a look at some things in Outlook. So let's jump into Outlook. And so the first thing that you want to do, like I said, is most of the time, come into Outlook, go to send and receive, and click on work offline. That means you're not going to get any other incoming emails. You can still get notifications from your calendar when it's time to do email, if you've got any other meetings already planned. And then when it's time to do your email, you can click that button again. It's going to synchronize with the server, update all your emails. And then as soon as you've got everything for that day or for that time period, you then want to click work offline again, so you don't get anything more pinging in as you're trying to process your email. So you can work offline on Outlook, obviously, and then when you click work online, it's going to synchronize anything you've moved or reply to everything that you've sent. So the first thing we need to understand about Microsoft Outlook and ToDo working together is if you're using the desktop app of Outlook on a PC and then click this little tasks button, that is going to show you all of the tasks that you've added in Outlook. And tasks and ToDo are very similar, but are not the same thing yet. I think Microsoft presumably is trying to get ToDo integrated directly into Outlook, but they have not managed that yet. So tasks have been around for ages, probably since Outlook was invented many moons ago, and can do a lot of the stuff, but it just looks a bit naff, hasn't got subtasks and stuff like ToDo has, hasn't got a mobile app that works that well, unlike Microsoft ToDo. So basically you'll try and get stuff into ToDo. But Microsoft Outlook tasks do sync automatically with Microsoft ToDo. And Outlook is a great program to have all your email, calendar, and tasks all in one place, at least to get it in there. So assuming we're in our email processing time, and this email was something I needed to take action on, although it's a particularly boring email that happens to be in my inbox to process right now, so I probably would just archive that myself, but assume we had an action to do on that. The quickest way to create an action in Outlook from an email is just drag it into this task list and let go. It's then gonna pop up another window, and it's got all of the body of the email in there. And we can put some start dates, due dates, status, priority if we wanted to, or a reminder right there. But for right now, I think we just want to get it out of our inbox as quickly as possible, and then we'll go back through ToDo and put all this stuff in if we wanted to. Best thing to do though is in the subject, remember to make that an action. So say I needed to do an action on this, that then is not really telling me what action I need to do. So it might be email IT back about this, because it's a pretty boring email. So click save and close. If we go back into tasks, that's created that one task in our task list, and we can see it in Outlook tasks. If we jump into ToDo, and this is gonna be the web version, but you can get a desktop app as well, then see there in my task list, it's got the same thing. So ToDo and tasks in Outlook are synced. But what we can't do in tasks in Outlook is when we click on it, it's got subtasks. So I might need to speak to, Simon, might need to arrange a meeting. Anything I need to do to complete that main task, I can do there. Also, tasks in Outlook doesn't have add to my day, which is really useful. So if I click that, it's going to have a short list in my day of stuff that I just want to do today. Assume I had a big list of tasks, I could go and filter the ones that I just want to do. It's got priorities, so you can star them and move them as important. And then remind me, due date, repeat, all the stuff that you would want to do. And then all the body of the emails saved in ToDo as well. So if your task was to send an email back, in this instance, so email IT back about this, I can't reply to the email from here, unfortunately. And even if we jump back into Outlook, I can't then email back about this either. I'd need to go through, because this is the task and not the email, and find the email to then go reply to it, which in this instance is quite easy because I've left it in my inbox. If I was doing this and bringing it out of my inbox, I'd move it into tasks and then hit archive, and it would go into my archive and I'd have to go and find it. So a quick way around that is that once you've dragged your task into here, so if I do it one more time and show you, it pops up and creates a task with all of that stuff in. So if I do email 2, just to make it a different task, although that should be what the task is in terms of what you need to do, and then go back to your inbox and then drag that onto that task window again, it creates then a little attachment of that email. And if I save and close that, it's then still gonna sync with ToDo. If we give it a couple of seconds. Okay, so here it is, email 2, and then it's got an attachment there, which is the email that we've attached to. So now when we need to do the action, assuming that action was to do with emailing someone, we've then got this little attachment, and if we click that, it's gonna open Outlook on the web, and we can then just got that email right there and reply or forward it on, or whatever action we need to take straight from that task, and then go back once we've done that, then go back and mark that task complete and get a satisfying little ding as well. So hopefully that's a nice little tip. Get your emails out of your email inbox and into a task management inbox, and also have that email attached so you can go back to the original email if you ever need to forward it on, reply, or do anything with it. So if this is resonating with you and you're struggling with too many emails before this video, let me know in the comments below, or just hit the like button to let me know that this is making sense so far. So then a couple of other things. If we use Outlook on the web rather than Outlook desktop app, then we get direct access to ToDo. So if we start by bringing up our calendar and task pane, calendar and ToDo, we can see ToDo right there with all the same benefits of having it in ToDo rather than Outlook tasks. So in Outlook on the web, ToDo is integrated into Outlook rather than it being tasks, bizarrely. And again, you can get ToDo down here and it's going to jump straight out into the web app. So if we go back through the browser back button there and click this little sidebar, we can then see tasks and we can change which folder we're looking at. So we could just look at the ones we're going to do today. And then similarly, if we needed to use this email to create a task, we just start dragging it over. As long as we've got this right-hand sidebar done, we can either then add it as an event or add it as a task. So we're going to add it as a task and it does the same thing. It creates that task for us. Then if we click on it, we can then put on our task description there, which again should be an action. And if we click into that task, we can then view that email straight from ToDo. So we didn't need to do that double embedding trick like we did in the desktop app. If we jump out to ToDo proper and go onto email task 3, we can then see it's got an open in Outlook button rather than it being a sort of workaround where we've attached that email as an attachment. It's not thinking it's a file, it's got it straight in Outlook. It does the same thing, pops open a smaller window for us to reply from or forward on or do whatever, but that is the original email that it's got. And then finally, if we jump out into Teams and go into Tasks by Planner, if you can't see that on your sidebar, it'll be in these three dots. If you don't see it in here, you would click on More Apps and go and find it, but it should be there and you can pin it to your sidebar if it's not pinned by right-clicking and doing Pin. For me, it says Unpin because it is already pinned. And there we can see the exact same thing. In the top bit, it's Microsoft ToDo that's showing up straight in Teams. So in the Teams view, just have some other limitations. So in the email IT back about this, which is where we dragged it in the Outlook desktop app, that created the body of the email as the notes section. So we can see everything in the email from there, as well as our subtasks that we added into Microsoft ToDo afterwards. If we click on the email task 3 one, which is the one that we've just done from Outlook on the web, where it's got a little button for us to jump back to the original email, that is not visible in Teams because that's just to do with the functionality on the web apps at the moment. If we looked at stuff that we had completed and went into email 2, then that's where we had the body of the email and then did an attachment, which you also can't see in Teams. So Teams is good that it's got the basics visible for you without leaving Teams, but not everything's fully aligned in functionality yet between Outlook desktop app, the web app, ToDo desktop app and the web app, and Teams and ToDo. Although what is beneficial is that you get all of your actions from ToDo, and then you also get all the actions from Planner. You can just jump straight to stuff from Planner in any team and any channel where you've got a planner embedded in Teams. So all of your tasks, whether the organizational ones or personal ones, once you've got it out of your inbox and into ToDo, you can see everything you need to do in one place in Teams. So Outlook and ToDo are great together for personal productivity. If you want to find out how to supercharge your entire organization with a complete digital transformation, then book a call using the link below to find out more about working together. So check out these videos next, and remember, click the like button, subscribe, and if you really like the video, consider buying me a beer using the link below in the description. It really does help support the channel and keep the content free on YouTube. Thanks for watching so far, and we'll see you in the next video.